Good morning, students. Today we will be discussing or focusing on the topic that is types of immune system. Types of immune system. In the previous class, you have completed about the basic concepts like lines of defense mechanism and cells, different types of cells of immune system and the different types of organs which are present in the immune system. So today we will discuss about the types of immune system. Before going to discuss about the types of immune system, let me explain some basic terms like immunology, immunity, immune system, like that. Students, in our environment, there are many types of microorganisms are present. Microorganism means it is a small organism which cannot be seen with our naked eye. They are present everywhere on the earth. They are present in air, present in soil, present in water. They are present everywhere. But every day we are exposed to thousands, crores and millions of these microorganisms. But only a few of them result in diseases. So those disease-causing organisms, those disease-causing microorganisms like virus, bacteria, parasites and protozoans are called as pathogens. Pathogen. Pathogen means disease-causing organism, whether it may be virus, bacteria or protozoan or any other parasite. Then why only a few of them result diseases means our body is able to protect itself from these pathogens with the help of immune system. So the capacity or capability of immune system, the capacity and capability of our immune system, of our body, is known as immunity. That means immunity means capability of body to protect itself from the disease causing organism, that is from the pathogens. Then coming to immune system, it also more or less gives the same meaning. That means the process or the system which involves a network of cells, a network of proteins and organs is known as immune system. Then coming to immunology. Immunology means it is a branch of science or branch of biology that deals with the study of immunity or immune system. So that is called immunology. Children, who is the father of immunology? Edward Jenner is the first person who invented the vaccine for the disease smallpox. Hence he is known as father of immunology. Who is the father of immunology? Edward Jenner. Edward Jenner. He is the first person to discover, who invented the vaccine for smallpox disease. For smallpox disease. and she is known as Barbara Jenkins. Then coming to the types of immune system, there are two types. Mainly they are divided into two types. The first one is innate immunity or innate immune system. The other one is acquired immune system. Innate. What is the meaning of innate? Innate means inheritance or inborn. Inheritance or inborn or congenital. The meaning of innate means inborn or congenital. That means in this type of immune system, the resistance developed by an individual or by an organism by birth, that is called innate immune system. It is not specific. That means it is not any particular to a particular disease. That means whatever the pathogen, whether it may be virus or bacteria or protozoan, whatever the pathogen, it will try to enter into the body, the first response shown by the innate immune system. That means its response is very fast. Its response is too fast. Irrespective of the pathogen that is entered into our body. So it is too fast to show its response. At the same time, it does not depend on prior contact with the pathogen. That means there is no necessity of any contact with the pathogen. Whether it is a malarial parasite or whether it is a smallpox virus, whatever it may be, it is ready to attack that pathogen. That is the main characteristic feature of innate immune system. Okay? That means it does not depend upon its prior contact with the pathogen, and it is non-specific. It does not depend on its prior contact with the pathogen. Then it is always on system. That means whenever the pathogen enters into body, it is ready to attack that pathogen. So it is also known as ready-made system. Then coming to acquired immune system. Before that, the mechanism of immune system, we will discuss about the mechanism of immune system. That means how it is executed. How it will prevent the entry of pathogens into the body. That means it is executed by some barriers like barrier means if suppose virus or protozoan a bacteria, if it wants to enter into the body, that means it tries to invade the body. Invaders. Invaders means who are trying to enter. They are known as invaders. So that means it tries to prevent the invaders. So with the help of barriers, this innate immune system, it tries to prevent the entry of pathogen into the body. Into the body. That means it inhibits the entry of pathogens. That's all. Then, coming to the barriers of innate immune system, it is executed by four types of barriers. The first one is physical barrier. Next one is physiological. Barrier. Third one is cellular barrier, and the fourth one is cytokine. Children, don't confuse here cytokine by hearing the word cytokine. Cytokine is some enzyme or secretion that is secreted by the immune cells. But cytokinin, whereas the cytokinin means, it is a plant hormone. It is a plant hormone. That is different from the cytokine. Okay. Then, coming to physiological, physical barrier. It involves skin. Physical barriers. Example. Physical barriers. It involves skin, saliva, skin, mucous membrane, mucous membrane, saliva, pH value, etc. Coming to the skin, it is a large organ of our body. It protects the body. That means it protects all the body parts. Similarly, mucous membrane is present as a lining of many organs. For example, mucous membrane is present in the stomach, saliva, then pH value, and also tears comes under this barrier. Skin and mucous membrane, they will prevent the entry of pathogens or microorganisms into our body in the first line itself. So they are said to be first line defense organs. So coming to the first line defense organs, skin and mucous membranes are very important role. If, suppose if any wound occurs on the skin, what will happen? The microorganisms enters into the body. Similarly, what is the function of mucous membrane means? This mucous membrane traps the pathogens that will enter into our body. So, these are said to be physical barriers, important physical barriers. Then, coming to physiological barriers. Similarly, the pH value, etc. The pH value of sweat ranges from 3 to 5. So, this pH value of oil that is secreted from the skin, and sebum which is secreted from the skin, and sweat that is also secreted from the skin, The pH value of sebum, oil and sweat ranges from 3 to 5. It inhibits that with this pH value range, it inhibits the entry of microorganisms into body. Then, coming to tears, saliva and HCl acid, which is secreted in the stomach. The tears contain a specific enzyme known as lysozyme. It helps to phagocytize the pathogens. What is meant by phagocytosis or phagocytize? Phagocytize the pathogens means are phagocytosis or phagocytosis. All of them give the similar meaning. That means engulfing the bacteria, engulfing the pathogens by the lysosomes which are present in the tears. Similarly, in the saliva also. Then coming to the HCl. This HCl acid is produced by the stomach. It helps to kill the harmful bacteria that enters into the stomach through the food materials. All these form the physiological barriers. We have completed physical barriers. Example, skin and mucous membrane, physiological barriers, HCl, saliva and tears, like that. Then coming to third type, cellular barriers. Cellular barriers. A lot of history behind the cellular barriers. It includes, it involves PMN, polymorphonuclear leukocytes. Then mononuclear phagocytes or leukocytes. Leukocytes are nothing but phagocytes. Why means they phagocytize the pathogens? They phagocytize the pathogen. That means they engulf the pathogen when they enter into our body. So, the cellular barriers includes PMN, polymorphonuclear leukocytes, and MNP, that means mononuclear phagocytes or leukocytes. They are also known as mononuclear phagocytes. Then, not only these are associated with some other cells, they are macrophages of the tissue. Macrophages of the tissues. And also they also include the natural killer cells. Natural killer cells. All these types of cells are originated from the leukocytes. And that means basically they arise from the leukocytes. Nothing but, in another way, the leukocytes are transformed into all these types of cells to protect the body. So, without white blood corpuscles or without leukocytes, there is no our immune system. So, polymorphonucleocytes comes under WBC, and mononuclear phagocytes comes under WBC, and macrophages also, they are nothing but monocytes. They are nothing but monocytes. Monocytes are nothing but a type of white blood corpuscles. Macrophages. Macrophages are nothing but transformed white blood corpuscles. Transformed monocytes are known as macrophages. Then coming to natural killer cells. What are those? They are nothing but the larger granular leukocytes, or otherwise known as natural killer cells. All these cells comes under cellular bodies. Okay? Then coming to the fourth type, with this I will complete the barriers that are involved in our innate immunity. With this we have completed the topic innate immune system. Okay, cytokine. What are the cytokine? Cytokine is, it is a secretion which is secreted by immune cells. Immune cells. These are secreted by immune cells. That means TH cell. For example, TH cell. TH cells are nothing but helper cells. They are nothing but smaller lymphocytes. Smaller lymphocytes are divided into TC cells and TH cells and B cells. These three comes under category of smaller granular lymphocytes. That means a type of lymphocyte. So cytokines are secreted by immune cells like TH helper cells. Whenever the pathogen enters into our body, the TH cells initiate the immune cells to secrete the cytokine. This secretions, that means cytokine secretions are two types. They are interleukins. They are interleukins and interferons. Interleukins and interferons. Interferons are nothing but they produce antiviral proteins. They initiate the production of antiviral proteins by the infected cells. That means antiviral proteins are produced from the infected cells. Why means? To protect the non-infected cells. That is the function of interferon. Then coming to interleukin, it helps in the differentiation of cells of immune system. Differentiation of cells of immune system plays an important role to phagocytize the pathogens which will enter into our body. Okay? With this, we have completed about the innate immune system. Then there is another system, that is acquired immune system or adaptive immune system. Okay?